Not yet. I just started.
Okay. Anyway, many of you are not familiar with the data simulation theory. Just before starting the introduction of my previous studies on the related to data simulation, we should share basic, but I really hate the mathematics equation. So please remember find just a concept of the data simulation process. That is just process of estimating the best estimated value combining from observations and forecast. You have forecast, right?
Yeah.
You have forecast. It is, yes, very useful, but it's sometimes wrong. So, we are doing observations sometimes, and somewhere. If we combine well, the best estimated value can be obtained from the process of data simulation. Just basics. So please imagine that what is the best estimated? What is the best estimated? Nobody knows the truths of the atmosphere, even from the observation. Of course, even observation has several errors. So you may think the accurately observed value is the best, right? But the problem is here. Unfortunately, even it has many shortcomings. You may know spatial and temporal resolution usually calls. We have a great spacing like that, but observation is very, very close. Jakarta and next one is much, much far from here.
Surabaya.
Yes, here is Surabaya, and we have Jakarta, right? So this is the shortcomings. And in homogeneous distribution, it is very, very difficult to use to analyze some specific phenomena. So especially for the ocean, over the ocean, we have much, much fewer observations. And this problem is really our problem. Diversity of instruments they are all characteristics or accuracy or some yeah. So we have Bessel double radar and radio sounds and surface weather stations. They all have yes merit, just like merit, but the diversity of the instruments set is sometimes confusing for the analysis for the, some phenomena, like something like that. The weather station has the much higher time resolution, but only for the surface. We have two dimensional observation from the radio sounds.
Yes.
But time resolution is very, very close. Right.
Video?
What music?
Yes.
From camera.
Camera.
Panggilan. Kalau
begini
apa? Bon. Kok ada bos?
The video can be broadcast. Okay. Anyway, we have 3D observations like a double radar, but it only have the observation there in the lower troposphere, or the lower troposphere. So characteristics and merit between these are entirely different. So it is also merit, but sometimes confusing us. So there are several shortcomings of the observation, spatial, temporal resolution, inhomogeneous, and diversity. But fortunately, a Fortias model can cover such shortcomings. Right? It's higher temporal spatial resolution, or so you should think. You can produce the best estimated value after the combination of the observations and forecasts. If it can be, it can be successful, right? Or reasonable for the grid dynamics or something like that. So that is the data simulation. The best estimated analysis, like a J-O-55, E-O-50, or interim, or something. We have so many observation, objective analysis data sets. sometimes using 3D bar or optimal interpolation or 4D bar and some car computer, something like that. But the basic is the same. The objective analysis is from the forecast value. But they have sometimes wrong. So it's called fast guess. Fast guess. Just forecast. So we need modification by the observation. Right? So just adding to the forecast part. So we call it observation increment. This increment means just difference between the forecast and the observation. That's it. So simply speaking, very simply speaking, the simulation method is how to estimate observation increment or modification. That's it. Not so difficult. In other words, the simulation method is how to estimate weighting coefficients for observation and forecast to determine the suitable modification. Right. So easiest way, the simplest way of the simulation is just average divided by 2. Right? But it's not zero. Right? But the simplest way. So we need to consider something for this weighting coefficient, not just average. time, but simple square acceleration. The basically the same. The other, even we use a 4D model or 3D model, something like that. So please look at the weighting coefficient. Should weighting coefficient for the suitable after consideration. For example, spatially, temporally, dynamically, smoothing. Right? So focus. This is coefficient instead of 2. There is no, if we consider a coefficient, this one, this is 2 and 1, and observation and focus difference should be added and that is modification. But it is not simple. Observation error is some value, and the focus error has some value. And multiply is different difference or increments between the observation and focus. And we get objective analysis for that. Now you know acceleration method is how to determine suitable background error, right? Because we know well about observation error from the measurement error, right? And we can easily determine here. Strictly speaking, we need to consider more the measurement error as a representative error. Right? But it's not so difficult. So we need to consider suitably for this. What is background error? So how to estimate, how to determine? This is assimilation method. So there is several, strictly speaking, background error like that is complex matrix of simultaneous equation like this. These each corresponding to each grid. So grid 1, grid 2, grid 3, grid 4. So you have each different value and each different forecast. So now you have forecast 24 forecasts from yesterday. Your forecast is temperature is 25. So next one is 26, next one is 27, right? Something like that. So each grid point had forecast value from yesterday, like a 24-hour forecast. That can be written by like this. But I don't strictly tell it because here you have complex matrix. So. Please skip it. Please forget it. Right? So one of the easiest way to the concept of the determining background error or from the forecast is using just prime trivial values. It's called optimal interpolation. Now we can easily find that the past current topology like this if we have data set. For example, we did forecast every day for 10 years, and we get this kind of parameterology at each grid. Okay. So background errors should be like this. Right? Should be like this. So values should be within this, because looking at specific grid points. Today you have 25. Yesterday you have 20. 1 year after you have 27. So background error should be determined easily. Looking at the past parameters. This is the easiest way of determining background error. That's called the optimum interpolation. That's easy. So going back to the this, we have some, we can determine some observation error, and the background error is from Kramatorskov paragraph. And we can suitable observation increment to add the forecast. This is the easiest way. So it looks like this. So now we have some past guess from the yes, this is forecast, this is analysis, this is observation. When we when they are all cross each other, Kramatorskov variance is like this. And we can decide some observation error like this. And considering the weight coefficient, small weight coefficient of the observation and large weight coefficient of Kramatorskov forecast background error, please look back this equation. So proportion to the background error is large. That should be a much larger increment. So larger modification should be done to the past guess. But if we have if we have several different values from the observation, the best estimate should be closer to the observation. But it's not observation itself, because of the observation also have the several errors like this. So considering the large forecast error and small observation error, and we can evaluate the best estimated value from after the combination of these two values, and we get the best estimated is here. This is optimal interpolation from the Kramatorskov variance. This is concept. But so, next, thinking about the dynamical constraints from the fluid dynamics. So we have an equation for the fluid dynamics in horizontally, in addition to the Kramatorskov variance. Of course, we use the Kramatorskov variance, and in addition to that, we can add some constraints from the dynamics. For example, wind system is like this. It should be satisfying the equation of the fluid dynamics, right? Something. So it's called. So it should be more suitable, more than the optimal interpolation. It's called three-dimensional variational method. That can including the consideration of dynamical constraints in horizontal at the specific time, only for this specific time, not for the time variation. So that's like this. We have now some values, and we have now some observations. We have now forecast values. Please focus on the shape of the forecast background error. It's not the shape of the true sample, because of the there is several dynamic constraints. So this value shouldn't be outside of the this tuple because of the after the consideration of the dynamic flow. So it's not just from the Clam-Terpstra bias. So after the, after we do a forecast something, right, using one, we got next forecast 24 hours or something. And but this is called a fast guess. But it may be wrong. So and we got observation at Jakarta. And after launching observation, and we need modification after consideration of the background error of the forecast and observation error, and determining the weighting coefficient to the estimate this kind of analysis. This is concept. And next one, after the consider the in addition to the temporal variation to the dynamical constraints, not only for in horizontal and yes, three dimensional, it's called just for the variational method. Yes, we can obtain the data from the forecast that this airflow structure is change in time, right? So tendency of the this kind of situation should be considered to the estimation of background error. So it should be more simple. It's called body variation method. It's like this. How to get the body dimension? Four-dimensional variation. Three-dimensionally, just forecast and the weighting coefficient estimation, and we get next analysis. But after the temporal tendency for some variables, I did several forecasts and added several. Several small values, and going back by the model, going back, and another fast guess here, and after the and using that another forecast like this, and going back, and that so then near the iteration, maybe more than 10 times or something like that. So we need a higher computational cost. That's for the bus system. So in the 4D bus system, we need to determine the temporal resolution for this iteration. If we took 6 hours, it's not so high computational cost. If we take 24 hours between this, much higher computational cost. We can easily imagine that. But much longer temporal window for this iteration, we can obtain the much suitable estimated value because of the after the consideration of the temporal tendency for the long run, right? It should be much more suitable. This is polyvalent. And the last one is the dynamical constraints from ensemble forecast, not from one deterministic forecast, ensemble forecast. For example, we have ensemble forecast of 10 members or 100 members, it has the spread of the value. Right. And spreads can be useful as well as political background. Because it includes this ensemble forecast spread includes the information from the temporal tendency. And also, of course, it includes the information from the dynamical constraint at the same time. Very, very useful. But of course, ensemble forecast needs much higher computational cost. So, for dimensional variation and ensemble forecast, it's the same level of the computational cost and the accurate. It's the same level of accuracy because of the same level of constraints, information from the dynamics and the temporal tendency. So now we have several ensemble forecasts for the specific time. But this is not time tendency, but we have several forecasts, and this means that. Background error. Also we have the so instead of the iteration of the body button system, ensemble forecast is several forecasts at the same time, and you estimate the forecast background error. Instead of the iteration, we can just use the spread, and we can get a weighting coefficient to estimate the next analysis. So any method needs binary observation error, including instrument accuracy. Maybe it's not. Instrument accuracy, many reactions. So, for example, radio sound temperature sensor should be less than 0.02 or something like that. So, company tell us about this instrumental accuracy. But we need observation error as a representative error. That is, in fact, unknown. Because what is representative error? So we get the radio sound observation at Jakarta. Of course, we have observation instrument accuracy on the main company. It should be less than a very small one. However, when we do a simulation for this huge grid, like 100 kilometers or 50 kilometers, or even in the 10 kilometers, this is not just representative of all grids, all areas of this grid. So there is several variation from this side to this side. Even we have the so now I observed the very very accurate temperature, and we get I get 25 degrees Celsius, but you have 25.2 degrees Celsius and something like that. So the observation is not just representative for all grids, right? So we need to consider the representative error. This is very big, as like a forecast error, right? So we need to consider the this kind of observation error. Maybe observation instrument accuracy should be like this. But adding to that, we need to consider the representative error, and we get this kind of observation error. And we need when we calculate the weighting coefficient for the next analysis, of course, observation error sometimes much, much smaller than forecast error, but it has several values. Like, for example, specifically, I use experimentally. Maybe operational agency all over the world using experimental use. For example, temperature is 10.1, relative humidity 10%. It's huge observation error from them. Yes, it's not just observation instrument accuracy. That's from almost a representative error. UV has wind field has around 1 meter per second. And now you know background error is changeable and R is observation error is constant. And we can easily calculate this weighting coefficients. And we can do the simulation process after using. After choosing some simulation method, optimal interpolation, OI, just parametric variation, dynamical equation, in, not only horizontally, in vertical. In addition to that, temporal tendency is called polybar, and ensemble current filter is. Use the focus on sample spread. Right. So just a sample, this is a sample from the data set. Optimal interpolation is used for usually SSC data sets. Maybe you know. And 3D bar is 1. And 4D bar is either inter and the general perfect bar. Because it needs very high computational cost. So JML or something, operational center, having the supercomputer, only can do that, can produce this kind of data sets. For this ensemble common filter data sets, this is my favorite data set. So from now, I will introduce data sets called ARIA. It is produced by Jamstack. Right. So of course you can available. It is available on this web address. Please search at Google, you can easily find it. ARIA. ARIA. This is ensemble forecast product. Yes, forecast model is general. Of course, it was developed by Jamstack, but it was general global surface model. It's not so that's, special. A simulation system is, strictly speaking, LVTK, local ensemble transfer current filter, but a kind of ensemble current. And the resolution is 1 degree, and ensemble members from the global saturation model is 63, and the observation data is used from the UCA, GDS, archive. It includes all radio sounds stations and over the world, and something like that. It is the same as the JMA datasets. And also, we need the boundary condition from the database. It's the same as the other objective analysis products. So now you can understand that like this. The most difference from the most important point for this ensemble stochastic, that's called stochastic data set, because ensemble data sets have ensemble analysis value at each grid. Usually we have NZ or ER or JR is one value for one parameter at each grid, like this. At grid X1, at grid X2, only have some deterministic one value, right? But ensemble data sets have, for example, 63 values for one grid of the temperature. Right. So we can easily estimate the analysis error from the variance. So we can easily estimate just looking at the spread distribution. This is spread distribution of the zonal wind speed at 850 hectopascal at Sunday, November 1st, 2006. And we have here operational summing size here. Yes. Here we have Jakarta winds. Jakarta winds. And of course, yes, they are all assimilated in this data set. You can easily find that the error around the operational radius on site is much, much smaller. But over the Central Indian Ocean, we don't have no observations. So there are huge error, three times the error over the maritime continent distributed over there at 850 hectopascal or zonal wind speed. Now we have a zonal wind speed of the this is 15 meters per second. So very big, weak wind speed, maybe less than 5 meters per second, but error is more than 3. However, around the maritime continent, it's less than 1 meter per second. So we can vary around here more than over the ocean. We can easily find that. But any other data sets, like GL55 or ER, cannot be produce this kind of information. Of course, after the de-assimilation of the intensive observation like this, we did the observation at Maldives Islands and the research vessel Mirrorized. We did operation intensive observations, and after the assimilation of these 3 points of radio sounds, the error over this region is reduced clearly. So we can easily find that the impact of the additional observation. This is most important merit from to use the ensemble data sets. So taking difference between these two data sets. Error with an additional observation. Error with the additional observation, we can get different error, 1, 2, and divided one from the original error, and taking difference, and we can easily define improvement rate, and how much distributed, and and such information gives us for this answer, where should we add observation in the trial phase? Which is yes, this is automatic launcher from the research vessel. So we need to choose the location of the research vessel like this, or which operational soundings should be much more intensified. So considering the limitation of the budget, we need a most suitable strategy. So we need to answer for this question. Where should we add spatial neutrons? Now we have three additional observations from the budget. So where should we from there? We have such the operation sounding sites over the wall. But you can easily near the target. Depends on the targets, you can think about, you should think about the position. For example, typhoon, for the improvement for the typhoon, we need to observe around this area and choose the huge area. And we think if you want to consider the winter monsoon, like cold surge, or like MGO, we need different strategy and methods. And after consideration, we choose several methods to observe by using aircraft or radio sound intensification, like this, 4 times is enough or 8 times is necessary, depending on the budget, and run station, like this. Anyway, you can easily find that this area is necessary to run by using research vessel. And we have several projects that have been done. It's for Parau over the Western Pacific to target. So the target for this project is typhoon, of course. So we use airport and draw several radio sounds sensors at these locations. And we can estimate the several impacts from the after the acceleration of these points. We only have the most of the drops on the location is within this area, but the observation impact, larger impact, means a warmer color. And it reached around Japan because of there is air force structure and of course a wave response or something like that. It's the information of improvement is reached up to the other region, and we can easily estimate that something. The other cases this year, we are just drops on the observation has been done, and after the assimilation, and the estimation of the impact, the reduced wind speed impact is here, and intensified wind speed impact is here, and this kind of pattern is propagated by along the anticyclone high pressure, and Japan has also some impacts from this area. And the other project during the winter, we have intensive observation at several points over the Philippines and Vietnam. We have 4 times, and so at some points only 1 time, but usually this operation station doesn't have no sensor, so we added one times per day, based on the observations, and two times or one time, okay, something like that. And how much impact? When we observe this kind of cyclonic disturbances pass away, and we have heavy rainfall in the eastern coast of the Vietnam, over the southern East China Sea, and there has a huge impact around the Philippines, like this, and it reached up to the Japan, even to Japan, even in their northern cold surge, against the cold, against the northern wind cold surge, it did propagate by some other phenomenon, like a wave response. So this is improvement rate ratio. So red color means the improvement. There are several deep ratings over the international. I don't know why that. Yeah. Of course, this improvement ratio is also have some error. So we need to check after we send this kind of experiment. So for the MISMO, we did the observation for the remarkable MGO passage over the central Indian Ocean, and we have additional videos on how much, how wide did the improvement area expose. So this is very interesting figure. This is my best favorite figure. Because this observation impact, yes, showing the much improvement of the broad region. Yes, it's more than 20,000 kilometers of overlap. This is huge. Well, yes, it is for a month, or one month. And also, I like that this shape of this improved area satisfies the theory of wave response. Very beautiful body. Just the same of Rossby wave response in the west, right? And the Kelvin wave response to the east. So if we added the several radius of the observation, it contributes to the accuracy of the information. Right? Even if it was just less than 1 month. It is huge benefits for the Indonesia or the between tropical countries. Right. So this is just not so you can find that this is not just assimilation, not for but just assimilation, but for the including understanding the phenomenon itself, right? Because this kind of information satisfies the theory. So, tracing the improvement ratio at some days, just after the first observation, it remitted in this region on the central Indian Ocean, of course. However, there was always carried by something like that. It propagates eastward. And footprints of the carbon wire is appeared in the and it visualized easily by improvement ratio distribution like this. Of course, you can easily imagine that. Well, and in addition to that, we have here typhoon generation of the coast of the equator around 15 degrees north several typhoon generation along this trace line. Another is Durian. So,
Durians?
Yes.
You know Durian?
Yes, Durian is in 2006. Maybe more than we have the cycle name music. So, not only for the acceleration impact, we can study and address the influence between Kelvin wave and Kelvin generation. To looking at the improvement ratio signal. So for example, this is the composite of the typhoon center. It's here, 0.0. It's here. And when Kelvin wave passed this, it has associated with improvement ratio by the Kelvin wave. And this is November 26th at 12Z. Please look at the next 12 hours. Right? It Kelvin waves is having much higher impact and to the typhoons. And it there it just synchronized and shifted to the east, and it weakened each other. But please note that this is not strength of phenomena itself. Just improvement ratio is weakened after the synchronization. Of course, Kelvin wave is going eastward, typhoon is going westward. If their positions are shifted in the south or in the west or east, the improvement impact signal is very small. But if it is the same longitudinal location, it has the maximum improvement ratio signal. So this is something to, there is a relation between the Kelvin wave and the typhoon generation. And like that. So improvement propagation by Kelvin wave reaching typhoon. Usually we can do the composite analysis from the statistical composite. And Kelvin wave signal is very, very weak for the explanation between this typhoon. There, for the fact that typhoon and Kelvin waves have correlated each other. But maybe that's it because of the climatological variance is very large, so signal is much weak. So not composite analysis between the relation for this phenomenon is very, very noisy. So usual composite analysis cannot be addressed or difficult to address this kind of relation. But this is just snapshot. And just looking strength of the improvement ratio. Oh, that's it. There is impact. So this is the application of the assimilation. One of the applications. And also we did the another field campaign, CD, in 2015. We have additional observation over the Martian continent. As the field campaign of HIMAP, maybe Morrison and Yamanaka-san in this project, and also at the same time we have another additional really some observations over Kenya, this Seychelles, Maldives, Sri Lanka, and Atlantic continent. And we had huge improvement during this Shimri campaign. So this is that's why my favorite data set too, because we can get this kind of additional information, not just improvement, to understand the phenomenon itself, or more potential improvement, actually improvement. Of course, improvement itself is very important, but also our purpose is usually the understanding phenomenon, targeted for phenomenon, much more improvement, or much more producing data sets. Okay. So this is my perspective on the data situation. So thanks so much.
Thank you so much, Professor Dr. Motegi. Dr. Motegi, for the presentation. So, explanation, basic explanation for data simulation, and also how the improvement of the simulation makes us understand more about the phenomenon, especially about the wave. Okay. Interesting. Perhaps any question from the audience? Any discussion? Any?
Yeah, it's very interesting, especially for how demonstrate the observation have improved to quality of surface, quality of the for example, surface. I mean that the prediction for something like phenomena. Yeah, so that's why we Lapan targeted the simulation technique is next step with me also important important step to we have to know about that. So thank you very much for providing topics about data simulation. And also
validation for the products after the simulation.
You explained your
just one of the samples of the simulation products and the application. But I didn't show the validation method or validation process. Yes, we need, of course, especially for the operational institute or operational agency, needs validation for this data sets itself. It was done from the other guys, so I couldn't show the specifically. For example. As for the Aurora datasets, validation has been done. For example, after using this dataset as the initial condition or boundary condition, and we do some forecast for the topical cycle or something. Some target phenomena. And as for the tropical cyclone, we have a best rock. That is true. So, comparing to that, which is better with the additional observation or with the additional observation, we can easily compare. And it was really improved. After the simulation of the additional observations. such kind of deportation has been done by the other guys for this data sets. But this data set is for the shorter periods, for even less than 10 years. So very, very shorter than the other operational data sets like GR55 or something like that. So we need much more validation steps. But yes, so in addition to that, we need much more users. And these data sets are used for various purposes, and it is suitable. It is not for comparing to the GR55. It's much more better than these data sets. And after the such comparison, such kind of process is also a kind of validation. So we need much more users and much more purposes and target and much more targeted observation. The most important merit is use of these data sets is much easier more than the other data sets.
Yeah, and I want also to thank you about what the purpose of the flight aircraft observation you explained. Actually, Lapan also have a plan to wrap.
Nice.
To convert our plane, our aircraft, actually is for passenger aircraft, converted to the laboratory aircraft. Flying laboratory, but now still certification. And you show that how important aircraft, for example, using drop zone to observe. Of course, other instruments.
That's maybe sounds nice. And if you provide such observations after doing the aircraft observation, we can easily do the impact simulation and provide back to the data set, and you can do this kind of validation or application. So,
yes.
If you do that, please be my thanks.
We are in progress. Next year, but I think that takes maybe 2 years more.
Would the improvement will be much lower or different? I mean, you are using LTTF for this one, right? For the simulation method. Would the result be much different if you use LTTF?
Sorry,
yes, the secret.
Maybe this is the past case to showing the improvement ratio directly, because the body variation was really variational method couldn't distribution of error information at each time. So, because the background error is from the current mainly origin ground earth variation. So it's not flow dependent background error. So we couldn't it is difficult to estimate this kind of improvement ratio and its distribution. So only ensemble system can show this kind of distribution of the error fields after considering the flow dependent dynamic. So if we use the body variation we could get this kind of
Thank you. So, is there any more questions? Alright then, we'll give a round more round of applause for the next presentation. We will continue after lunch break.
But before leaving, I think I have to take a photo first. But this is yeah. Jam 1:30 ya. Mau lanjutin nggak? Terserah. Berapa lama Pak Mili? Tolong.
Ya bisa di skip.
Mau jam skip. Moderator.
Saya ikut aja, bisa skip.
Iya, foto aja dulu.